oxidizing agent found naturally. And therefore, PS2 is considered as the strongest oxidizing agent. Why? Because to remove electron, the removal of electron is called oxidation. So, it is this much strong that it will lead to the photolysis of water. So, actually, this photolysis of water is done by a water spreading complex, which is also known as oxygen evolving complex. Now, here the important aspect is I have written the one water molecule is split, but actually, this is a protein bound inorganic complex. This is a protein bound inorganic complex. Students, this is a protein bound inorganic complex containing 4 Mn plus calcium ion plus chloride ion as a cofactor. So, this is a protein bound inorganic complex, that is oxygen evolving complex, which is situated on the inner side of membrane, contains 4 Mn plus 2 ion plus calcium plus chloride ion as a factor. This will lead to, now these 4 manganese complex actually combine with 2 water molecule instead of 1 water molecule. Now these 2 water molecule went actually undergo splitting, produces 4H plus plus 4 electron plus 1 molecule of oxygen. But this reaction or these electrons of this reaction is completed when the final reaction occurs along with generation of NADPH. So the important reaction is 2 NADP plus plus 2 H2O plus 8 photons. 4 photons accepted by PS2 and 4 photons accepted by PS1 and releases 2 NADPH plus 2 H plus plus 1 molecule of oxygen. Means to produce 1 molecule of oxygen, we actually require 8 photons. Now what happens during this whole process? The first thing, the photolysis of water occur, which is actually occur by the water splitting complex or oxygen evolving complex. And finally, this water is taken from the human side of helicoid and it is converted into H plus plus O2. So oxygen is produced towards the lumen and proton is also poured into the lumen. So this first reaction increases proton in lumen side. The second one is when these 2 protons are accepted by plastoquinone, and when plastoquinone combined with cytochrome B6F, it transferred these protons to the lumen side. This is the second process. And from this second process, the 2H plus which is present on the stroma side is shifted to the lumen side. So the second reaction also increases proton towards inner side and it decreases proton towards outer side. And the third reaction, when these electrons finally reaches to the FNR, which is also known as flavoprotein phenylalanine NADP plus reductase, this accept this H plus ion from stroma side, which undergo decrement, and finally it is converted into NADPH. So what will happen? In this third reaction, the H plus on stroma side decreases. Now again, first one, because of the water splitting complex or oxygen evolving complex, the water is taken from the lumen and it can undergo splitting and produces H plus ion as well as O2. So, because of the production of H plus ion towards the lumen side, or these H plus ion are shifted to the lumen, the amount of proton in the lumen increases. In the second reaction, the proton on stroma side decreases and the proton on lumen side increases. And in the third reaction, the proton on stroma side decreases. And because of these 3 reactions, the pH inside the lumen becomes 4. pH decrease means H plus ion increase. And pH on outside becomes 8. Now there is a vast difference in the pH. It means there is 10,000 times increase in proton inside the lumen in comparison to the stromocyte. Now the important aspect is this single thylakoid membrane is especially impermeable to these protons. The only permeable part which is present in this membrane is F0 particle of F0 F1 unit. So the last complex or important complex is F0 F1 unit, and this F0 particle is actually act as a proton channel and it is embedded in membrane. So this is act as a proton channel which is embedded in membrane. Now the important aspect is because the proton gradient is created, this gradient is actually break by this F0 subunit, and these protons are transported from this F0 particle, because F1 subunit, which is also known as ATP synthetase or synthase enzyme, when proton is transported through this ATP synthase enzyme, they cause or they release enough energy to change conformation of F1. So what happens during this decreasing concentration gradient, when proton transported from high concentration to the low concentration, the energy is released, and that energy is actually required for conformational change of F1. And when the conformational change of F1 takes place, it will react ADP plus IP and convert it into ADP. And this is actually the final process where what will happen? Phosphorylation. What will happen? Phosphorylation. But actually that phosphorylation occurs because of proton gradient. Proton gradient is created because of excitation of electrons. And excitation of electron occurs because of light. So indirectly or directly, this light generally leads to the formation of ATP. Therefore, this process is known as photophosphorylation, and this is called chemiosmotic hypothesis, which is actually proposed by Michel. And the important aspect is this FNR, which is also known as NADP reductase, it is occur free in stromine monomeric form, means it is also found in stroma as well as it is also found in bounded form. Clear? Stroma में जब होगा तो कौन सी फॉर्म होगी मोनोमेरिक, और जब ये बाउंड होगा तो कौन सी फॉर्म में बाउंड होगा डाइमेरिक. वेयर इट इज बाउंडेड? इट इज बाउंडेड ऑन आउटर साइड ऑफ मेम्ब्रेन. क्लियर? एंड हियर